Are you looking for a new way to get listings? Today we're going to talk about my low pressure approach on old expireds, and it's fire. I am what I am today, cause I did it my way, nothing y'all can say. What's up guys, Ricky Carruth here, Remix of Orange Beach and ZeroToDiamond.com. Today we're going to be talking about my low pressure approach with old expired listings. So old expireds, let's just say, are sellers that have their property on the market. It didn't sell for whatever reason and it expired from the market, or they could have withdrawn it from the market. Either way it goes, they had their property on the market at one point and now it's not on the market. And when I say old expires, this means that it didn't expire today, it didn't expire yesterday or last week. We want to go back. We want to go back several months worth of expires. We might want to go back a year, 6 months, 9 months, 3 months, 1 month. It just depends on your market. Maybe you take a month a year ago, you know, maybe you take October last year, or, you know, you can figure out, depending on your market, you know, how you want to filter down exactly what you want to do, because bigger markets are going to have a lot more expired. Smaller markets are going to have a lot less expired. You may have to go 6 months and use all 6 months worth. So I don't know how far you got to go back for you and your particular market. I don't know exactly. You know, there's also different niches. You know, you have the lots, you have the houses, you have a commercial, you have condos. So you have all the different kinds of real estate, you know, that could have expired. And then you have different markets with larger numbers and smaller numbers of expired and withdrawn listings. So it's up to you to kind of figure out, you know, how far you want to go back and how you want to do all that. You have to put in the research there to figure out what's best for you. But what I want to discuss today is exactly how we're going to A, find these people, and B, what we're going to say to them to engage with them and get into these conversations that is going to create that lifelong relationship. And remember guys, I've said this in many other videos, that it's relationships over transactions. Our goal is to create that lifelong relationship, maintain that lifelong relationship, and we're going to reap the benefits of that relationship through 10 to 20 deals over the life of our career, through repeat business, referrals, and referrals of referrals. So we don't want to let anybody go. We don't want to not engage with somebody or not create that relationship with a prospect just because they don't want to sell today or just because they don't want to buy today. We want to begin that friendship, that relationship for the rest of our life, and there's no telling where each and every relationship is going to take you. It's amazing how your life can change with this one philosophy change. It's a complete 180. And when you value relationships over transactions, your business and your life just start to go up, 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 and up day after day. And when you adopt this philosophy and you start applying it in your business, you can see that you're having different conversations with people, and your prospects and your future clients are responding to you differently, and they're actually talking to you like you're a friend or a family. And at that point, you know you got them, and you know that you're gonna be their realtor for life. And that's the goal, that's what we want. So the first thing is, how do we find old expireds? Okay, so what you're gonna do is go in your MLS, you're gonna go back, you're gonna search expired listings, the criteria you want, you're gonna put the dates in, and you're gonna find all of those expired listings or withdrawals. Okay, so you're gonna find all of those old expireds, and then we're gonna use Redx. Redx is where we're gonna find the phone numbers. If you don't already have Redx, there's a link in the description below that will save you the $150 startup fee. They will waive that for you if you use the link below. Redx is where I get all my phone numbers. This is the best quality phone numbers that I've found across the entire internet. It also has a dialing system that will dial the numbers for you if you wanna do that as well. But I would definitely get Redx to find the phone numbers. Now when you're getting old expireds, there's a bunch of different ways you can do it. And I would say, I don't want to get into all the details of that right this second, but if you call Redx, if you have any problems getting the numbers, just call Redx and they will walk you through how to get those phone numbers to the old expireds in your MLS. Okay, so the next question is, after looking at this list of old expireds,
Do we wanna go through all the research and take all the time to go through every single property and find out, did it sell? Is it back on the market? What's going on? What's the status with that property? And I would say that that's a personal decision. I would say that you just have to decide if you wanna spend that time or not. I personally do not feel like I wanna go through all of that time. I'm just gonna go and start making those calls and start making those connections and kind of see where it goes. If I do run into someone who is listed now on the market or already sold or so on and so forth, all these other scenarios, I'm just gonna smooth it over and play it off. I'm gonna see if there's anything I can do to help them go to the next level with whatever they're trying to do, and I'm gonna go on to the next call. If it's listed, I'm gonna say, sorry, I didn't notice that. Yes, I see it right here. I'm gonna do everything I can to try to sell it for you, but I'm gonna contact your agent from here on out. You have a wonderful day. So there's a couple of different ways you can handle that situation. You can go through and do the research and try to pick everybody out, or you can just make the calls and smooth it over when you run into those situations. I like the latter because it saves me time and it just gets me in contact with people right now. Also, before we get into the phone scripts here in a second, I did want to let you know that this Friday, I'm going to be calling Old Expireds Live right here on YouTube. So there's a link in the description where you can click and turn on that notification so you can get notified when I go live. That's gonna be 3 p.m. Central Time this Friday. So what do we say to these old expireds as we're calling them, okay? So we're gonna follow my phone scripts, okay? All my phone scripts can be found at zerotodiamond.com. So we're gonna follow the script and we're gonna say, ring, 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 hello. Hey, Mr. Johnson. Yes, Mr. Johnson. Hey, Mr. Johnson, this is Ricky Carruth down at RE/MAX of Orange Beach. How you doing today? Doing good. Yeah, me too. I'm enjoying the weather. Isn't it gorgeous? Cool. Look, I don't want to take up too much of your time today, but I see where your property expired off the market back a few months ago or whatever it was, and I didn't know if there's anything I could do to help you at this time, right? And so we're going to pause right there and let them talk. Right? We're just kind of trying to fill them out. Where are they in this process? What's on their mind? What's going on with them and this property, and how can we help them? Okay, so we're gonna see how they respond. A big part of making phone calls and a big part of being successful in this business is reading people on the phone and in person, but reading people, right? And also not playing all your cards at once. I know that I can ask them, hey, do you still wanna sell your property? You know, hey, why do you think it didn't sell? I've got all those questions as ammo, right? But I don't want to shoot all my bullets and run out of bullets immediately, right? I want to feel the situation. I want to give him a chance to respond, him or her, and let me know how they feel about the situation. And then if it's a friendly conversation and I feel like things are going good, then I'm going to ask more questions. And so when I ask him if there's anything I can do to help him or her, there's a number of different ways the conversation can go. But my ultimate goal is to, if I feel like there's an opening, I want to know, hey, do you still want to sell it? You know, do you still own the property? You know, why do you think it didn't sell? There's a lot of different things I can, you know, places I can take the conversation right there. And I wanna have that conversation. I don't wanna figure out what's going on. From there, I wanna lay down the next part of that script, which is, look, is there an agent that you're gonna work with on this deal, right? I wanna find out, does he have a strong relationship, an affiliation with another agent that's gonna prevent me from being his listing agent? Because if there is, then I gotta decide if I'm wasting my time here or if I wanna compete with this other agent, okay? So that's another situation that I have to read out. And then I just finished the rest of the script. You guys know the rest of my script. And at the end of the day, either way it goes, we want to try to get that email because we're gonna plug them into our weekly email report that goes out every single week on the same day of the week forever. And I've been doing it for 11 years, and it's the reason why I'm so relevant with all of my clients. And it's a big reason why I'm where I'm at in this business, is because so many people know who I am through this email. And it's one of the biggest hardcore principles that I'm teaching in my free coaching program. Okay, so from there, if they are interested in selling, if they do still own the property, I'm gonna read that situation. And my goal at that point is, if they do wanna still sell, then I wanna find out if I can see the property. I'm gonna try to set that appointment and go there, look at the property, evaluate it, and try to see what I can do to help this seller accomplish what they're trying to accomplish. So that's the next step. Another big reason why I like old expireds is because it might have expired because it was overpriced back when it expired, but now the market's improved, and now the price that they had it at one point that it was too high may be a really great price in today's market. So this is another reason why I like old expireds a whole lot. And to me, I just feel like the old expired market is gold. I feel like there's a lot more old expireds than there are current expireds, and it just gives you more of that sky's the limit, you know, business is unlimited mentality that I try to share with you guys. So I hope you got something out of this video, and I'm really looking forward to calling old expireds live right here on this YouTube channel, Friday, 3 p.m. Central. So if you haven't clicked subscribe, now would be a good time to do that. Turn post notifications on so you can see when I go live and post other videos just like this one. I'm just a small town Alabama boy trying to make a difference in the world and help reduce the failure rate in the real estate industry. You guys let me know if there's anything I can do for you, and we'll talk to you soon.